Hello, it's Shanice again, and this is the WCAG Documents project focused on web accessibility. In this video, I will talk about the WCAG criterion 1 for 11, non-text contrast, and you can also read it online at accessibility.actumdigital.com, where you will find more information. So let's get into it. The intent of the success criterion is that user interface, components, and graphics have enough contrast against surrounding colors. Who benefits from it? Well, people with visual impairments can see and recognize the visual elements. And anyone can see the contrasting user interface better. Non-text contrast is a contrast of user interface components, graphical objects, and their states against the surrounding colors. To meet this criterion, you need to ensure contrast ratio of at least 3:1. User interface components or UI components are the elements that make up the graphical layout of an application or website, enabling interaction between the user and the software. These include buttons, text fields, checkboxes, sliders, and menus, among the others, which are essentials for users to navigate, input, and control the software functions. Users must be able to recognize the component thanks to the sufficient contrast ratio between the color of the component and the color around it. This applies to all component states such as focus, hover, or active. Adjacent colors in all these states must have enough contrast ratio. Graphical objects are visual elements like icons, charts, images used to represent the information of concepts in a more intuitive way. They complement text by visually conveying the message or data, making it easier to understand or interact with the content. Not every graphical object needs to contrast with its surroundings. Only those that are required for users to understand that the graphic is conveying. The 3:1 contrast ratio requirement does not need to apply to the following: inactive or disabled components. However, if you aim for good accessibility and not just compliance, you ensure enough contrast for these two. When the appearance of the component is set by user agent browser and not modified by author. But again, we recommend to go beyond the WCAG and ensure enough contrast for these two. When the particular presentation of graphical objects is essential to the information being conveyed, such as logos, photographs, and screenshots. When the information is available in another form, such as in text or inside the table, or pure decorational content. Now let's take a look at some examples. The following example shows the correct usage or implementation of accessibility. Inputs with enough contrast. The form contains two input fields for email and password. User can recognize the inputs thanks to the black border that exceeds the minimum requirements for a contrast. Users with vision impairments or users in challenging lighting condition should be able to see it well. The following example shows the incorrect usage or implementation of accessibility. The inputs with insufficient contrast. The form contains two input fields for email and password. Users would have troubles recognizing inputs because of the light gray border that does not meet the minimum requirements for the contrast. Users with visual impairments or users in challenging light condition might not see the input at all, not knowing there is a form. And that was all for this video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.